YouTube, what's up guys? It's your boy David and I'm back again with another tutorial. Today I'm going to be demonstrating how to do a mid to high fade, and these are the steps. We're going to grab our skeleton pairs of trimmers and we're going to do our guideline from the temple to the head, and we're going to go about half an inch above the occipital bone. We're going to ball that out with our Bronze Series 9. Then we're going to grab our Babyliss Gold FX clippers that are not zero gapped. We're going to create a guideline that's about a finger thick. Then we're going to erase that guideline, grab our one guard and open up the lever and create another guideline to soften it up using our close to open lever method. Then we're going to grab our 0.5 guard and blend that out. Detail this fade out really quick to get this end result right here, guys. This is a blurry fade, and these are the utensils that I use for the fade. I mentioned soft pairs of trimmers. Soft just means that they're not zero gapped. These are not modified. So my soft pairs of trimmers is the wall, and then the Babyliss Gold FX clippers are my soft pairs of trimmers that are not zero gapped. The rest are zero gapped, and those are the utensils you guys are gonna use. And if you guys haven't subscribed to my channel yet, guys, hit that sub button, hit the like button, comment down below and let me know what I can do for you guys better in terms of the tutorial. But to start off the tutorial, like I mentioned in the beginning of the video, we're gonna first identify our occipital bone, which is the bone that protrudes from the back of the head. And that's just the guide that I always use for all my fades, mid fades, low fades, anything. You always want to make sure that you identify the occipital bone, and you guys can see from the side there that it just protrudes from the back of the head. Everybody has a different size occipital bone and it lands at different parts of the head, but for this mid to high fade, I'm gonna try to aim about, you know, I'm gonna try to hit it on the dot. And other clients might have a different location for the occipital bone, so it's your job to identify that. And we're just gonna create the first guideline with our skeleton trimmers that are zero gapped, and we're gonna do it on one side and then we're gonna connect it on the other side. So I like doing one side first. I take down the bulk, then I do the other side just to guarantee that both sides are gonna be even. Once we set that crispy guideline, guys, the next step is to use your shaver, whatever shaver you guys might have. For this tutorial, I'm using my Bronze Series 9, and I'm only using one side of the shaver because every single time I use the double side, I feel like I don't have control of how much I shave. Because in these steps, you have to make sure that you're just keeping a nice soft hand and you're not going all the way up, because that's how you create some really harsh lines. And I like leaving a little bit of room so I can go in with my trimmers again, flip them upside down. They're a lot sharper in this angle, so it allows me to blend that ball transition into the stubble, which is what creates a nice blurry fade. So you guys might have questions on how to erase that zero line that a lot of people have. The key is just to keep a little bit of room between the shaving and the trimmer so you can blend that transition out. So using our soft pairs of clippers, these are not zero gapped, I'm gonna open up the lever and create a one finger guideline. And you guys just wanna go smooth like that. You guys don't wanna use a lot of force. Let the machine do all the work. And we're gonna set this guideline on one side of the head and we're gonna do it on the other side. And a key thing you guys have to keep in mind whenever you guys are setting guidelines is consistent guidelines are gonna equal consistent results over time. So just make sure you guys take your time when you guys are setting these guidelines and make sure that there's no dark spots after, because when you go and you blend these out, it's gonna be a lot harder for you guys to get a crispy blend. So just stay consistent and just keep flowing until everything's nice and perfect. Another extra step I like taking, my soft pairs of trimmers. Like I mentioned, soft just means that they just come straight out the box like that. They're not modified, they're not zero gapped. And I just like baby tapping that line just to make it a lot easier for my workload, you know, with my magic clip. When I go in and I blend out that line, it just makes everything easier. You guys might be asking yourself, why do you take so many steps? You know, if you guys want extraordinary results. You guys have to go the extra mile to really make sure that everything is gonna be nice and crisp and nice and consistent. To stay consistent with your process and find a system that works best for you. To erase the guideline, guys, first you just want to double check and make sure that everything's nice and crisp, but open up the lever and hit everything. Then we're going to put our lever in the middle, hit the guideline in the middle, and little by little we're going to keep going higher into the guideline by opening our lever until our lever's completely open. We're going to hit everything again, close the lever, baby tap the beginning of the line, go higher and higher, keep opening the lever as you go higher until we're left with the lever completely open, and we're going to hit it again. And that's how you erase the line. And right here I'm going to demonstrate, my lever's open, I'm going to hit everything, and I'm going to be working in zones. So we're going to be going from the ear to the temple of the head, and we're going to fade out this side of the head, and then we're just going to keep going in zones of the head. And right here I double check that everything is nice and even, so then I can put my lever in the middle. And guys, you guys have to use the corners of your clippers whenever you guys are blending. It's a different process versus setting guidelines. You use the whole blade of your clipper, and right here we want to be a little bit more precise, so we're going to use the corners of our clippers to do all the work. So as I'm working towards the left side of the head, I'm using the left side of my clipper, and as I'm working from the ear to the temple, I switch up and I use the right corners. So just make sure that you guys differentiate the process of you guys setting guidelines versus blending. And I still have my lever in the middle right here, guys. I'm just going back and forth, and I open it a little bit and I'm gonna go a little bit higher. And like I mentioned before, guys, consistent flow and a consistent process is gonna yield consistent results. So you have to make sure that you're moving in the same motion, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, and you're applying the same amount of pressure in every side of the head. Because if you put more pressure, your machine is gonna cut more, and it's gonna allow, it's gonna mess up the consistency of your fade. And you guys can see here how I'm going a little bit higher and higher and higher as I keep opening up the lever. And right here I'm gonna close it. You guys can see the little smudge at the bottom. That means that I'm doing a great job in this blending process because I didn't have to work that hard. That's why I like starting in the middle. It just makes everything a lot easier, so then you can see your work at the end and do what's hard at the end. Because usually the people that start with their lever closed, they end up going a little bit too high into the fade, and they have to repeat the whole blending process. And that's how you get people like that mess up haircuts. They end up going higher and higher and higher, and that's because they start with their lever closed. Start in the middle, guys. It works best when you guys are blending the first guideline out. And this lever method is called the middle open closed method. For the whole tutorial, I'm gonna be doing closed to open, but for this first guideline, I'm just gonna do middle open closed, and I'm just gonna demonstrate one more time in the back of the head. Like I mentioned, I work from the ear to the temple, and now I'm working from the back of the head towards the ear. So it just guarantees that everything is gonna be blending out step by step, 25% of the head, 25% of the head, and I just keep moving in that flow until everything is nice and clean, and then I can move on to the next step. You guys saw how clean that first guideline was blended out. Now we're gonna attach our one guard, and we're gonna grab our babyless clippers, and we're gonna set a guideline that's one finger thick, that's proportional to the guideline that we just set. So do the same thing, guys. We're gonna set the guideline on one side of the head, and then work our way to the other side of the head, and make sure that everything is consistent and there's no dark spots and no uneven spots in your guidelines. Another great gem you guys can take from this video is once you guys set a guideline on top of a guideline that you guys already blended, it's gonna show inconsistencies in your blend and dark spots. So that's why I went in with my babyless clippers, and I opened the lever, and I just made sure that those dark spots were completely erased This is called lever play. So you guys are playing with your lever and kind of just playing around with it until those lines are completely blended. As you go higher into the guideline, you want to make sure you open it. And if it doesn't hit, just close it one notch and just keep using the corners of your clippers until those dark spots are completely blended, so you can move on to that guideline and finish blending it out. What you don't want to happen is for your guideline to just all of it to be inconsistent, and then you have to come and correct your work at the end of the fade. I like correcting my work in between guidelines. So this step can be fairly tricky for a lot of people. In terms of difficulty, blending this guideline out is the hardest thing of the whole haircut, in my opinion, because it's a two-step process. So the first step that we're gonna do, we're gonna grab our one guard and close the lever and baby tap the beginning of the guideline. And this is gonna be called the closed to open lever method. We just start off by closing our lever, baby tapping the beginning of the guideline, and we keep opening our lever as we go higher and higher into the guideline. Just like I've mentioned before, just stay consistent in your flow, stay consistent in what you do, and take your time, guys, because if you guys don't do a good job in this step, it's gonna be a lot harder to blend out using our 0.5 guard, which is gonna be the second step after this. We're gonna do close to open around the whole head, and this is gonna soften this line out, but it's not gonna completely blend it. Then we're gonna grab our 0.5 guard and apply the same method, closed to open, guys. That's the beginning of the guideline. We're gonna start closed and keep opening it little by little by little until our guideline is completely erased. You guys can see how I softened it up already. It's almost completely blended. But guys, don't go all the way up. This is the trickiest step in the whole haircut tutorial. We only have half the room of the guideline that we set initially. Use the corners of your clippers and just keep flowing, guys. Just stay consistent. Use the corners of your clippers, just like I've been repeating this whole haircut. Everything is the same thing. It's the same system. You guys just have to stay patient. A lot of the times is that we get impatient and we're like, this is not blending out. It's not blending out. So we just like going to another side of the head, and then we half-ass another side of the head, and then it just ends up being a half-ass haircut. Just make sure you guys stay true to your system and you guys are moving in zones of the head so you guys can stay organized in your fading process. And now it's gonna be the same thing, guys. Pretend that this was just the previous step. We have that last line to get rid of, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna soften this line out using the close to open method with our two guard. So our two guard is going to be like the one guard that we just used, and what we're going to use to blend out in the second step of this process of this step is we're going to use our 1.5 guard. So our 0.5 guard and our 1.5 guard are blending guards. I like to call them blending guards because they just bring the fade together. And right here, I'm going in with my two guard with the lever open, then I'm going to close it and do the close to open method and just soften that line out to make it easier for me to go in with my 1.5 guard. After softening up that line, guys, we're gonna do the same thing, close to open using our 1.5 guard. You guys can see the dark line right there that I just softened. It just gives me enough, you know, room to work with because I can see the darkness. I can see that that's the line that I need to blend out, so I can focus on it and I can just use the corners of my clippers just to work in zones. And this step can be very, you know, tedious, but just stay patient. Patience is the key when you guys are using your 0.5 guard and your 1.5 guard, because things might not seem like they're blending out, guys, but just keep brushing and brushing and brushing and go back and look at your fade and make sure that you guys are just taking your time. After finishing the lineup, I like going in with my YS Park comb. This comb is pretty thick and it's perfect to hit around the 0.5 to 1.5 fade region. So I like using it to detail my fade out, any dark spots. It's all about the dark spots. Dark spots just means that there's extra hair that's messing up the consistency of your fade. You guys can see how crispy this fade is coming out. And just taking the extra time to detail your work is gonna go a long ways. Simply, your clippers are not gonna do all the work. It's not gonna completely give you the best fade if you just use your clippers. You gotta use other tools. You gotta use your tools. And right here with my straight razor, I'm stretching the skin with my other hand. And another great tip that's gonna take your fade to the next level, that this step just takes about 2 minutes to do, but it makes a big difference. Stretch the skin and always remember where you placed your guideline, your first guideline, and just hit it a little bit below that initial first guideline that we set with our trimmer. So it's gonna go from that shaver to the straight razor to the trimmer that we hit upside down. And then it's just gonna create that nice crisp transition. Right here, I'm gonna apply a little bit of enhancements on the side using some hair fibers just to take my work to the next level, guys. You guys want to be able to apply extra enhancements for your clients. This is just the cherry on top, guys. This is not meant to disguise any inconsistencies. This is just meant to enhance. I'm not hiding anything. I'm not, you know, I didn't push his hairline back or anything. And here, just I'm just polishing the fade. After all of these steps are just meant to polish and polish and polish. Polishing is just another fancy word for detailing. If you guys have made it this far into the tutorial, give yourself a pat on the back, guys. You guys have invested in yourself. You guys have taken the time out of your day to really just watch this tutorial to enhance your skills, to enhance your craft. This is the after, guys. After doing every single step in this haircut tutorial, the detailing, the guidelines, the lever methods, this is what you get when you apply the same system that I use. The same system that I use might not work for you, but if you can take one or two or three things from this video and apply it in your own system, it's gonna go a long ways. This is the before, and this is the after, guys. Super blurry fade, mid to high fade. It's really Corsair. Shout out to my guy Parga for just sitting down. You know, this guy works overnight, so this guy was tired. He came in around like 7:30 a.m. and he sat for 2 hours while I cut and I recorded this full haircut tutorial. Shout out to anybody who's ever gotten a haircut from me and allowed me to really record my content for you guys. I appreciate you guys for tuning in to this haircut tutorial and my channel. I'll see you guys on the next one. Thank you.